And that's another aspect of love, creation. Whether you're creating a child or creating a bond. Yes. You know, and I love to teach about this in my my talks and my lectures.
February 2nd.
Where is
it at?
It's called the Singles and Soulmates Relationship Boot Camp.
We're going to help. Everything relationship related.
We are going to help people understand themselves and understand why they've been blocking love. I'm really excited to do this one. I am so excited.
We might need to stop by, Brian.
Exactly. But you know what's really interesting, going back to what you were just saying, is that with all those contrasts in your life, at 10, at, you know, having the two heart surgeries, there was something, I believe, in you, and you probably can tap into it better because it's you, that had self-love. You knew there was a greater purpose at 10 years old that made you stop.
You know, Brian, that's a great comment. I didn't, and I did. I did know as soon as I got that, and I have to excuse my poor description of it, but a miracle. I mean, it was a miracle. I knew at 10 years old that there was more to this life when I got that, like, almost like a slap in my hand. It was like a slap in my hand that dropped the razor. Because I was like, so young, I just was looking at things.
Like,
and it said, no. And I believe it was a guide. I was one of my guides, 100%. One of my angels, whatever it was. And I knew immediately, like, it planted in my head, it's the environment that's sick and you're here for the reason to change it or to do something.
And not to be a part of it. Mm-hmm.
Then I had the courage and the ability, the inner strength to actually survive it all, because it didn't end. It kept on going. But then I was more sad for the people that were abusing me in my classroom and, you know, beating me up every day at 3 o'clock and, you know, after school was over. I was more sad for them than I was sad for me. And that's when it changed, when I became the victor instead of the victim.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And that was huge.